a lot of the conversation is about the operational support that the Commonwealth provides, but we also help with the building and facility needs, primarily with the Key 93 allocations from a portion of the realty transfer tax that's been in place for quite a number of years, and also with capital budget dollars. So you provided an overview of what you're seeing with the facilities need in the universities. Can you just elaborate on that a little bit to anything that you want to point out related to the deferred maintenance and what that means? Because I'm looking at the average age of your buildings, and it's like pretty old. So,
first of all, thank you for the question. It is back to what I said about FEA. First of all, cling to the Key 93 program. We're lucky to have it, and the General Assembly and the Governor continue to be wise in supporting it, because as you can attest to, we just don't have extra money that we can put into things like deferred maintenance and construction projects, and that money is critical to us. But to your very good point, Representative, and to put a number on it, you talked about the age of our facilities. As I mentioned, we're 175 years of age at many of our institutions, 150. It doesn't mean our buildings are, but we've been around a long time. And 54% or more of our facilities have not gone through an organized renovation process in the last 25 years. We do everything on triage, as you might imagine, from deferred maintenance, and oft times because of declining funds, we will patch a roof instead of replace a roof when you really should replace it, or you're going to pay the piper somewhere else. So we have a mounting backlog of deferred maintenance, and we really do on that score, and our presidents do a terrific job. Take care of the bleeders first on the deferred maintenance issues, but it's still allows for many deferred maintenance possibilities to go untended to. Key 93, during 14-15, our NG facilities expenditures, $13 million, Key 93 on deferred maintenance, but also the universities kicked in $37 million from their own ENG budgets or their reserves on the issue of deferred maintenance. And capital appropriations spent on us was about $35 million out of a $65 million pot. It isn't that we put the rest into a Christmas Club account, but many of our projects are large enough where they have to be parsed out, and you have to have the money, but you can only do phase one, phase two, or whatever it is. So, again, a testament to Key 93 dollars. Keep that up. That's my take on that, and I, if you'll indulge me, I wanted to see if Dr. Driscoll might have anything he wanted to say about deferred maintenance especially.
Well, I will repeat the thanks that Pennsylvania has invested at the level it has, and to keep doing that. We have significant challenges. My office is in a 141-year-old building that's in okay shape because it was renovated, but we have a growing backlog of deferred maintenance issues and are left with facilities that are not adequate in a high school in some cases because we're not able to keep up with the current demand and needs for instructional technology. Keeping buildings open and functioning becomes more and more expensive in these times when we can't modernize and renovate. So more would be great, too, I guess.
Just as a follow-up, I mean, I listened to you talk about your emphasis on STEM studies. So do those STEM courses and programs require a higher level of maintenance or more modern buildings? Or, I mean, it seems like they may go together.
Yeah, and Mike might be a good one to field that one. But the short answer is yes.
Okay.
The next significant construction project on IUB's campus is a new sciences building to replace a building that was built in the early 60s and has been doing yeoman's work for the last 50-plus years. We cannot provide adequate power, cooling, networking, et cetera, in that building for today and tomorrow's technology. We've done a wonderful job with our alum who have been successful in speccing what we need for the future. It's a great, great project, and it will cost anywhere, just rough numbers, not on this particular project, but science engineering facilities generally want 50 to 100% higher per square foot than just a normal classroom building might do.
And to add, at East Strasburg University, we have a Science and Technology Center. It's our nicest, most new building on campus, as a matter of fact. So from the recruitment perspective, I was a campus tour guide and an orientation leader for 2 and 3 years, respectively. It's a great selling point, no doubt. But it is hard to sell your product called ESU when buildings, you know, aren't as competitive as some other universities that students are looking at. So I do, just to echo their comments.
No, and I asked that thinking of my own experience of working at a major research university and in the biomedical research area. I know, you know, wow, it's just unbelievable the progress that has been made in a lot of these areas, but also then the great need. So thank you for answering.